400 years of the history of the greatest nation on earth. It all began on this day with a prayer meeting and the erecting of a cross.
Be thou my vision, O Lord of my heart.
If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray, seek my face, turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven. Ah, that's good news this morning. And will forgive their sin and heal their land. Now, he didn't say if the whole nation will do that. He said if my people who are called by my name, that specifically names us. So shall we pray these words? I'll pray and you set yourself in agreement with me. If my people which are called by my name, Father, this morning we pray in the mighty name of Jesus, that name that is above every name that has been given unto men. We humble ourselves this morning and we pray before the throne of grace and we seek your face. Hear this morning, O God, our repentance as we act on your word and turn from our wicked, unbelieving ways. You have promised, then I will hear from heaven. It is from this moment forward, on this rededication, confirmation, covenant morning, that you are listening. You are hearing from heaven, and we receive the forgiveness of our sins. And we pray for the sins of this nation and for the sins of all godly Jesus people all over this planet. We receive your blessing among us this morning, and we receive this day as the turning point, the defining point of our history for these last days. And we thank you for it in the mighty name of Jesus. If you agree with that, say amen. Amen.
But this shall be the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel. After those days, saith the Lord, I will put my law in their inward parts and write it in their hearts, and will be their God, and they shall be my people.
When we bought this land here, there wasn't anything on it except trees. And as part of our dedication of the land, about a year after we bought it, we went down to Cape Henry, and we had a demonstration, if you will, of people with costumes of the continents of the world. And they came up the beach carrying a 7-foot oak cross. And they brought it to the place of that other cross. And at that point, we took the names of all of the donors of CBN and we placed it in that cross and then prayed. Lord, we humbly hold before you the names of all these donors and this cross, and we ask that you might revive us, that you might let the anointing of your Holy Spirit flow upon us, that in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we might be used for your glory to take the gospel around the world. We commend this group to your keeping, and we pray your blessing. Let the anointing flow today, we pray, and from each successive day. I now take these names, and I place it in this cross that was brought to this place from Cape Henry, where this nation began on April the 29th, 1607. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Praise God. I'm going to ask every one of you to take your programs, if you would. And on the front page, there is something that's called the covenant promise. And above it is written what was attributed to Robert Hunt: from these very shores, the gospel shall go forth not only to this new world, but to the entire world. And what we're going to say, I want us all to repeat this together. It says, the covenant promise. And I'd like us all to read it together as a solemn affirmation of the covenant that was made 400 years ago by Robert Hunt and that group of 105 English settlers that came on those three tiny little boats. So if we'd read it together, in remembrance of the 400th anniversary of this sacred moment in time, we reclaim the Holy Covenant of 1607, and we reaffirm that America is dedicated to our Lord Jesus Christ for His glory and for His purpose, and to confirm our nation's mission as described in the prayer of our forefather. The gospel shall go forth to not only this new world, but the entire world. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah.
So, Lord, we just ask now for forgiveness, that you would break us, that you would bring us back into your perfect will. Send now salvation, Lord God. And Lord, we ask once again that America would be part of your plan. Part of your plan and purpose and our destiny is to preach the gospel to every nation.
This is my body broken for you. This do as oft as you eat it in remembrance of me. This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Drink ye all of it. And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord cause His face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up His countenance upon you and give you His peace. In Jesus' name, amen. Oh.